Hi everyone, this is Bharati. Today our topic is Floating Logos. Floating Logos is actually a program to float an image or a logo throughout our website. In our websites, multiple web pages are there. In those web pages, we want to only single logo or single image to display that single image in every web page. We can done that with this program. So how to do that program, how can we write that, and what is that program? Let's start that program. So start the HTML page with opening HTML tag, and in this we are opening the head section. In this head section we are writing the scripting tag. In this scripting tag, we are declaring two variables. One is x1 and another one is y1. These two variables are representing the coordinates for the image, whatever the image we are displaying in our web page. So here we are giving the coordinates for the x1 is 11 and the coordinates for the y1 is 130. So this x1 is representing from left side to adjust the x coordinate, and this y1 coordinate is from top, it will adjust the coordinate. And this document get element by id and not document dot all, this is the condition if our website contains single page or multiple pages. So this condition is satisfied when if only the document contains single page and not the multiple pages, then it will be true, both will be true, then only this DOM equal to true will be condition will be executed. Otherwise means if the website contains multiple pages, that is document dot all is false, then DOM will be false. So here we are taking two conditions, one is DOM is true and another one is DOM is false. Here we are declaring the first function, typestrat function. In this function we are mentioning for the condition if DOM, that is if DOM is true, then we are writing a division. So for this division we are giving the id as logo box and style as position as absolute, and from left side this division will start from the left side of the window inner width minus x1. X1 is the 11 coordinates, so 11 pixels will be subtracted from the window inner width, and visibility is visible. So this division visible and style is position absolute, and this inner width will be subtracted by the minus 11. And when this executed, if DOM is true. If DOM is false, then this in this typestrat function, this condition will be executed. Means if the website contains multiple pages, then this condition will be executed. That is, in this document.write, we are writing a division with the id as logo box, style as position as absolute, and from the left side, this division will start from the client document dot document element dot client width minus x1. So x coordinate will be subtracted from the client width of the document element from the document object. So as we are scrolling in the web pages in the website, so client width will be varied from the one page to one page. So from that client width, from every page, it will subtracted minus x1, that is 11 pixels, and visibility of the division will be visible. So this is the type start function, and we are writing another function in this program, that is type end function. In this type function, type end function, we mention for both document dot all and document DOM, we mention either this will be true or this will be true. That is, either it has single page or it has website has multiple pages, then this document dot write will be executed. in this we have written division tag global will closed. So when where the type start function executed, that division tag will be started displaying in the web page. Whenever the type end function will be executed, then only this division tag will be closed. And here we have written another function, that is placeit function. In this placeit function, we have given two conditions. If DOM is true, means here if the website contains single page, then we are getting that element by ID. In that document, we are getting the document by using it element by ID as logo box, means it is a division, right? Logo box, we have given the ID for the div tag in the type start function. So that will be getting in this function, placeit function. And here we are setting the style from the top is equal to window dot page y offset plus y1 plus pixels. So this style is setting for the division tag in the if the single page is there, and y coordinate is setting here, that is page y offset. So offset is the coordinate is setting for that page window dot page offset. Here we are setting plus y1. So y1 is previously we mentioned here 130 pixels. So plus 130 pixels will be added to the page offset, so that in that place only. So for the web page, the page offset is taken. So page offset plus y1. So 130th pixel from the top to the page will be added. There only y coordinate will be taken, and same like that x coordinate will be set. Like this only from left side it will be set. So here we are getting logo box, that is div tag. That div tag style from left start, so it will start from left side, and it's start from left side of the page of x starting is the x1 plus x1 coordinate. Is we here we are adding the coordinate 11 pixels. So this will be executed when if the website contains single web page. Otherwise, if the website contains multiple pages, then this condition will be executed if DOM document dot all. So in this we are getting the same div tag from the document dot all object, that is from the website. And here we are setting the style from the top, and that style we are giving here from document object, the document element scroll top element, we are adding y1 coordinate to the scroll top, that is whatever page we are there, in whichever page we are, from that page we are adding from top position to y1 coordinate. So 130 pixels will be added to this logo, means div tag, that is logo box, that is whatever we are displaying the logo. Next, same like that x coordinate will be added to the div tag, that is whatever the logo we are displaying for that logo box. Here we are getting that logo box for the multiple pages of the website, and here we are setting the style from left side, and here we are adding from left side x pixels from the scroll left for the document or document element scroll left. So here x1 pixels will be added to the logo box, that is div tag, and here y1 pixels will be added from the top to the logo box, that is div tag. Means this div tag represents the logo. And here for that, after the two conditions, that is if website contains a single page, otherwise website contains a multiple pages, we are executing window dot set timeout function. This set timeout function will execute it. Here we are giving two parameters. One is place it and another one is 10 milliseconds. So this place it function will be called for after every 10 milliseconds. So logo box will be whatever the image we are giving in our web page, that web page will be called the logo after every 10 milliseconds by using this function. Now we closed the script tag and we closed the head tag. Then we open the body tag. Now we are calling those functions whatever we have written in head section. Those functions we are now using in the body tag. Here onload means whenever the page is loaded, that time only this place it function will be called. So in place it function we have mentioned here the logo box, where to set the logo box we have mentioned in the place it function. So our logo will be placed in our web page whatever the dimensions we have given in place it functions. After that we have called type start function in script tags. So this type in type start function we display a division tag, and this division tag will be started in the type start function. So it is not closed in type start function, so it will be displayed the logo whatever we are given in our web page. So it is displaying whether the user is scrolling or whether the user is not scrolling the web page. So the type start function division tag will be displayed. Here we are taking the image. So here the image source will be taken from where it is the logo is saved. So that address I have given in this source src attribute, and I have not mentioned any border for that logo, and that logo width will be 100 and height will be 81. So this is the image I want to display in my web page. Whatever the image I want to display, I given in this image tag. So already division tag is started and place it function is already running. So this image is here placed when the browser is open, and this image is started displaying in the type start function. This will be closed in the script type and function. As division is closed, so that type and function is called after the type start function. So type and function, so when I call the type and function means div tag is after the all pages in the website are displayed, no more pages are there, then only I given here type and function. So after all pages are over, then this type and function will be called and my image tag is displayed there, and scrolling will be stopped here from the type and function. I closed the script tag, and now here I have given some text for my web page to display some text in the web page. This is nothing is there, just a sample text is given to scroll the page. So here I want to add some more text to scroll the web page, because this will be sufficient only for the sum of the page only and not more than one page. So I want to add some more text. Here I am giving some more text. So here I have given text for the web page till here. So nothing is there, just one heading tag, that is H3, floating logo is there, and one paragraph and pre-formatted text and I am repeating this preformatted text and that paragraph in the preformatted text in this web page. To scroll the page only to execute the program. So saving this program, Control S. So floating logos, this program, we will execute this program now. This is our output. So this is the image we have taken in source. So scroll it the web page. So whenever we are scrolling the page, the image also moving up and down. So this is the floating logos program. So in this program, this image is moving freely from one page to another page. Here we are given only one page. So if more than one page is there, then also it will be scrolled from one page to another page. Okay. Thank you.